Hi friends, myself Bhavan Jha from Biology Guru. I have these topics from class 12th biology. These are crucial for board as well as all pre-medical exams. Today's topics for discussion are adaptive radiation and saltation from chapter 7 and commensalism and gauge competitive exclusion principle from chapter 13. First one is adaptive radiation. It is process of evolution of different species in a given geographical area, starting from a point and literally radiating to other habitats. Examples of adaptive radiation are Darwin's finches and Australian marsupials. Darwin's finches. These are small black colored birds observed by Darwin on Galapagos Island. All birds had common ancestor and evolved on the island itself. Originally they were seed eating, but some became insect eating, that is insectivorous, and some other became vegetarian, that is fruit eating finches, by evolving their different shape of beak. Australian marsupials. A number of marsupial animals, that is paused mammals, each different from other, evolved from an ancestral stock, but all within the Australian island continent. Convergent evolution, when more than one adaptive radiation appeared to have occurred in an isolated geographical area. Example, Australian marsupials like marsupial mole, marsupial moss, numbat, spotted cuscus, etc. and placental mammals like mole, mouse, anteater, lemur, etc. Mutation theory of evolution. It was proposed by Hugo de Vries based on his observation on wild variety of evening primrose, that is Oenothera lamarckiana. Evolution for Darwin was gradual, while de Vries believed mutation caused speciation, that is formation of new species, and called it saltation. Saltation means single step large mutation. Mutations are random and directionless, while Darwinian variations are small and directional. Next one is commensalism, that from chapter 13. Relationship between two living individuals of different species in which one is benefited while other is neither harmed nor benefited, that is plus zero interaction. Examples are an orchid growing as an epiphyte on a mango branch. Orchids are benefited by getting shelter, but the plant is neither benefited nor harmed. Second example is barnacles growing on back of whale are benefited while the whale doesn't. Next example is cattle egret and grazing cattle in close association. The egrets always forage close to where the cattle are grazing. As the cattle move, insects are flushed out from vegetations. The egrets are benefited, as otherwise it might be difficult for egrets to find and catch the insect. Interaction between sea anemone and clownfish. The clownfish gets protection from its predators, which stay away from stinging tentacles of the sea anemone. Next example is pilot fish remora always accompanies shark without getting attached to the same. It feeds on falling pieces of food when the shark eats the prey. Gauge competitive exclusion principle. Two closely related species competing for same resources can't coexist indefinitely, and competitively inferior one will be eliminated eventually. This may be true if resources are limiting, but not otherwise. Species facing competition might evolve mechanisms that promote coexistence rather than exclusion. One such mechanism is resource partitioning. Resource partitioning. If two species compete for the same resource, they could avoid competition by choosing different times for feeding or different foraging patterns. MacArthur showed that five closely related species of warblers living on same tree were able to avoid competition and coexist due to behavioral differences in their foraging activities. Thank you for watching.